It is Martina Trevisan who will be starting us off. Sophia Miak with you for the remaining of the day. Well, it's an easy start so far for the Italian. Definitely not the tallest player out there. 5'3", 1.60 meters, but oh boy, can she run. Very quick, low center of gravity, definitely helps. What a great first serve here to hold that lob. Just the way the doctor's order for Martina Trevisan. What a start. Lefty going to the tee. You normally wait for that ball to go more on the slice wide just because of the easiness it is to hit as a lefty. Just the same thing that right-handed players do when they hit to the deuce side. They have the tendency to have more and an easier way of going through the arm and the motion through the ball to the wide serve right here, for example. That's exactly what she was trying to do. Well, she made it, Nicole. Yeah, that's a great play. Very aggressive from the racket of Sasnovic. And the hold, back-to-back hold. For both players. Trevisan had a very difficult time the beginning of her career. She was one of the top junior and then had to stay away from the game for over 5 years as she battled anorexia. Very difficult, but so happy and so proud that she today is back and what she's been accomplishing, especially coming back on the tour. Beautiful 1-2 punch. The serve definitely puts Sasnovich on the defensive. Right here, and that's the slice I'm talking about, going away from the body of Sasnovich. Not so far. I think they're both trying to be aggressive, and whomever is really on the front foot is the one that's winning the points right now. I talked a little bit about their first and only account for in Roland Garros, that was this year, on the red clay before Trevisan reached the semifinals. So it was a tight match. And in the first set, Sasnovich had a first set point in the first set tiebreak at 9-8, lost the first set 12-10 in tiebreak with Trevisan, had to wait on the fifth set point to take the tiebreak. And then in the second set, Sasnovich served for the set at 5-4 and was broken at love, losing three games in a row and eventually the match 7-5 in the second set. Like I mentioned, it took 2 hours for this match. Yeah, very good drop shot, good feel from the racket of Sasnovich, and yes, a much better feeling also in this game than the opening game where Trevisan held that love. Now a chance for Sasnovich to break the Italian. Nice defense from Trevisan. And by the way, in this match they played at the French Open, Roland Garros, Sasnovich had 5 double faults, and the serve and return of were very important because 21 combined break points in that match. So you know that this is something that both players want to do, is be aggressive on the return. Look at Sasnovich standing inside the baseline. Yep, definitely more aggressive. Second break point here for Sasnovich. Well done from the Belarusian. Able to break on the second break point here, and she will be serving at 2-1 in this opening set. two games to one here. Well, one thing she didn't do yesterday is hit any double fault during your match, which was very impressive because that's sometimes one of her Achilles' heel. Lovely acceleration, just taking advantage of any short balls right now. Sandra Sasnovic, winner of that forehand cross court. Also a winner here in 2017 at the Open de Caen. That's great response. Why not? If you can't do it, I can too. Yesterday, Sasnovic beat Alice Robbe from France, and interestingly enough, she was up 6-2, 5-love, 40-all, and she won the match on two back-to-back lead cords winner. That was tough, very tough for Alice Robbe. Trevisan with two chances here to break back, but first one, she made quite a mess of that one. Yep, she knows it. A big difference here in that return, just well placed, and it is the break back. Last encounter between the two was at the Roland Garros French Open, and 21, as I mentioned, combined breaks that day. So it's not a surprise right here. The return to serve being much more important than the serve so far. Well, that's the perfect example of how important the return is, just because the serves are not really their forte, and any time that a serve is like short in the box, you know that both these players are going to try to attack. What a response that was from Sasnovic. Play to come forward, ask the question on the pass. Did that a lot in the first set tiebreak yesterday. Trevisan against Akanjali, and he really did help winning that set and eventually the match. Oh, she's got it. It's called definitely cleaning the line. Look how forward she gets with that ball going towards the bounce to get closer to it and hitting that so early. Well, it is a good hold, considering that was not an easy game for Trevisan. But thank you to the mistake on that last returner serve, and Trevisan in the leading right now, 3-2. Oh, what an angle, especially from far away in the court. It's not easy to get that little pocket. Good accuracy. Šefčovič, even though she didn't win a title this year, she did reach 2 finals, one in Melbourne, the 250 event in Cleveland, but definitely her best year reaching your highest ranking. That was 29 not long ago in September, now sitting at 30 in the world. On the tour starting in the ITF in 2010, Šefčovič, so definitely knows a thing or two about being a professional tennis player. Oh, beautiful. That was very powerful backhand, flattened that one out, and earlier she had that little jump backhand also. But this one, oof, a little jump here, pushing Trevisan really far away from her line, but this one is absolutely gorgeous. Well, it helps when your first serve is in the box. Very quick around that backhand to trigger once again a winner. Šefčovič evening things out at 3-3. Eight winners so far for Šefčovič in this match, 4-2 on the other side, and equal amount of unforced errors for Sasnovich. Well, that's three and four errors in this game. Guess what? Sasnovich again looking at break points opportunity. Three in a row. Wow, from love 40 to being able to come back with a little help of her opponent for short to 40-all. Yep, another chance for Sasnovich here to break for the second time of the match. Both players able to break once. Not quite yet. So quick to get a run that backhand and trigger the forehand inside out. Sasnovich. Very quick footwork. Adjustment steps. Oh, that is overruled by the umpire. No argument from Sasnovich. We've had a lot of overruled today so far. Now back to deuce after saving three break points. Trevisan in this game needs a first serve. Yeah, it's just too short in the court from the racket of Trevisan right now, and every time that happens, the return of serve was pretty exceptional considering the serve was right at the body, but every time the ball is a little bit short, you can be assured that this woman right here is going to step into it. What? And still no joy on the fifth breakpoint opportunity for Šestanović. Longest game of the match so far. Well, Šestanović yesterday was able to paralyze 5 out of 6 times on break points against Alice Robe. Today, not exactly the same story so far. She's 1 for 8. Wow. Yep, that shoulder is sure getting a lot of work right now. Long game. Needs to push on those legs to get over that net, though. Well, the question is, and remains, who wants it? Didn't climb that wall well enough. It was way above her shoulders and really didn't accelerate through the ball at impact. And that floated out. Breakpoint number 6 for Šestanović in this game. Well, finally, she kept on going, she kept at it, and she's rewarded. Šestanović breaks again for the second time in this set and gets in the lead here, 4-3 in this opening set. Oh, that is too much on that one, but absolutely amazing defensive skills from Martina Trevisan. good on Sasnovic to stay with it. And this acceleration on that last shot was absolutely magnificent from the Belarusian. An ace for Sasnovic. Well done. First ace of the match. Well, those three first serve definitely huge for Sasnovic to be able to consolidate the break. And now leads five games to three, putting the pressure on Trevisan to serve to stay in the set. That's in. I guess she definitely deserved to get that line, just being aggressive, taking risk, going for it. Shot selection has been pretty good for Sasnovic today. Getting dangerous here for the Italian. Unless they would have come back with a much better serve. Using that left serve. Oh no, she wanted to go for it. She did it, but unfortunately just missing the mark. Almost looked like she didn't finish quite her swing. That racket didn't go through towards the target. And surely Sasnovic enjoying this. And Forster with a set point. Wow. Serve was good, but not that great for Sasnovic to completely miss the mark in the court on set point. That was huge. Yeah, that's a good, good depth. Second set point for the Belarusian. Thank you. Yeah, she's not going to be happy at all about this return to the bottom of the net. Second back-to-back set points where she missed the return. Well, when you take the ball early like this, it's absolutely unplayable. Give yourself one more chance here. Will the third be the lucky one for Sasnovich? And third time, lucky it is for Sasnovich. He finally was able to put the return in and takes the first set, 6-3. Pretty long rally here, choosing to go with the drop shot a little bit too short, obviously. Half open door here to try to take the serve of Sasnovich, who served really impeccably in the last service game. Well, keeps at it here. Second ace of the match for Sasnovich. Well, this is similar to what she did to lead 5-3 in the first set, just by hitting an ace and two first serve winners. From love 30 to now. Perfect. 40-30 in this game, so 3 points in a row. Bit up and down here, to say the least, for Sasnovich. Facing a break point in this opening game of the second set. Not ready to consider serve here, Sasnovich. So again, the winner coming from the forehand inside out this time. just very inconsistent from both players, just not able to win those 2 points in a row. Well, Sasnovic finally does that. Winning those 2 points in a row with that tremendous forehand down the line. Very aggressive going forward once again inside the court, which is helpful because of the shortness of the shots of Martina Trevisan. So it is one love here in the second set. Good hold, considering that she faced break point. So Trevisan serving here, love one. Missing the mark here. This long, good get from Trevisan with that swing volley. Way to make your opponent hit one more ball. How low did you get here on that forehand? The squash retrieval shot. Yeah, that's coming way too fast. Trevisan not able to get to that ball. Two top 10 scalps for Trevisan in her career, beating Gabina Muguruza in Rabat, and she won the tournament. And also in 2020, beating Kiki Bertens at Roland Garros. Definitely trying to be aggressive on the return, but this one doesn't make it over the net, and Trevisan gets a hold here, even things out of 1-1. Sasnovic serving, and Sasnovic 2018 was on the list of the WTA Most Improved Player of the Year because of her finished in the top 100, but so were other players like Julia Gerges, Daria Kazatkina, Elis Mertens, Wong Kong, and Kiki Bertens. And it's Kiki Bertens who got it. But it's pretty amazing to be nominated already. Speaks very highly of your performance. Yeah. Well, definitely having a pretty good day on serve right now. Third aces for Sasnovic. Served very well the important time earlier in the first set. Great kill, Sasnovic at the net, for sure. Not afraid to come forward. No, this backhand is definitely showing her ability. Tennis career high ranking of 39. That was in August 2021. Now playing a little bit more emphasis on the singles, but ranked 100 in the world in doubles. Sasnovic right now. Talk about power here. Another winner from the racket of the Belarusian, and now in the lead 2-1 in this second set. Wow. Talk about being able to create an angle with the ball coming right at your body. Was able to step out just enough to create enough room between her and the ball to inflict that beautiful return winner of the forehand inside out. Not quite the same here. On this serve to the body. Not a bad play to play the body. And player 5'9", Sasnovic. 1.74 meters, so not easy to get around the ball sometimes. Yeah, she's definitely returning a lot better than Trevisan throughout the match. More depth, more power, more aggressive. Wow, it looked like she was going to hit a swing volley, but changed to an overhead and was definitely not set for that. Great get from Trevisan, who was kind of like laughing a little bit at how lucky she was to get out of this point for sure. Evening things out at 2-0. I don't know if you noticed, but the toss of Sasnovich is way to the left so many times that it's so difficult for her to get that racket back to hit the tee. She's putting a lot more pressure on the Italian, just more aggressive altogether, but the Italian needs to find more depth. Fantastic depth from the Italian. And with that, also being able to finish it on a full run with the winner. Find the pocket, even though Sasnovich was covering her line. That was not an easy play. Opportunity here for Trevisan. Needs to be more aggressive, hopefully, to get a second serve. Let's see if once again can Sasnovich get out of trouble because of the quality of that first serve. Can't do it this time, and it is Martina Trevisan now ahead and trying to consolidate this serve break, leading at 3-2. Quite an up and down match, really, for both players right now. The great if they could both play well at the same time to give us a little bit more of an entertainment on this match. Oh, lucky. Just like yesterday. Winning her last 2 points of her match yesterday in her semifinal against Alice Robe on two let courts. Two let courts winner, mind you. And just like that, so she is now facing two breakback points. Trevisan not doing enough. A little bit unlucky also with that lead cord, no doubt. Nicely done from Trevisan. Felt like she was playing deeper. Was a little bit more aggressive. Just the fact that she's pushing Sasnovic off her line is definitely helpful to win points. Still a break point. Oh boy, that is not an easy shot. That ball is low and you're going to the highest part of the net. That's the way to save yet another break point. Third breakback points for the Belarusian. Best point of the match so far, I would say. Everything was in there. The movement from both players, the feel, change of pace, and then finishing it at the net for Martina Trevisan. Moving forward on that backhand volley. Definitely a difficult physical point. Both players. Well, that'll help Trevisan here not have to fight for this point after a long rally. A chance to consolidate the break after being down 15-40 and the break point saved. And that's the lefty serve. I'll give her now a consolidation of the break and a lead of 4-2 in this second set. Well, the WTA awards were given not long ago. Player of the Year, well, not a surprise, Iga Świątek. She has played some tremendous tennis, to say the least, in this year. The doubles team of the year, not a surprise either, Krejčíková, Siniaková. One surprise, though, for me, most improved player was Beatriz Adadmaya. Not that she didn't have a great season, went from 65 in the world to 15 in the world, but I think that Caroline Garcia should have gotten that one. 74 at the beginning of the year to number 4 and winning the Fort Worth WTA Finals for the French woman. I think that would have been hers for sure, but it was not to be. A newcomer of the year, Jeanne Quinion. Comeback player of the year, that one. Totally agree with Tatiana Maria. Coming back after having her second child and making it to the semifinals of Wimbledon. What a year this has been for Tatiana. Great family. Fantastic for her to receive that award. Nicely done for Sosnovic. A hold here. And, surely Trevisan taking advantage of, again, the unforced error from Sosnovic, and getting closer and closer to pushing this match into a third set. Another great defense from Trevisan on the return of serve, and the amount of power that Sosnovic was able to provide. Look at that, how low she gets to get that return, and then eventually pushes Sosnovic once again to the enforced error. It is three set points for Trevisan here. Third set here for this women's final at the Open de Caen for that 16th edition of this event. Trevisan able to even things out at one set all. Sosnovic starting here in the third set. She's going to have to clean a little bit of the amount of unforced errors that she gave and the point she gave in that second set. Showing up, Trevisan took full advantage of it. Yes. White steps up. Inside out. Forehand return for the winner here. And Sasnovich right off the bat in such huge trouble. On the verge of being broken in the opening game of this third set. And that's the way to battle. And to stay with it for Trevisan, just making Sasnovich play one more ball. And it's paying off. First break of the third set goes the way of the Italian. 37 unforced errors total for Sasnovich in this match. That's quite a bit. Comparing to 22 winners. 15 minus 15 differential, that is not what you want to be. It's way too far away from each other. Only minus 10 differential on the side of Trevisan. 17 unforced for 7 winners. That's what right-handed player can do. Inside out, backhand return. Winner looks exactly the same angle that Trevisan was able to have in the opening game with the forehand inside out. Let's enjoy that eighth winner for sure. And a 1-2 punch. It's just so short in the court. You see this just bouncing. Maybe a meter past the service line. You have to be able to hit deeper than this. It's almost what's been going on throughout the match. I would go maybe with just a little bit less tension on the racket. Wow, tipsy-turvy match, to say the least, between those players now. He's on facing 2 break points. Yep. So we've seen throughout the whole match, just very difficult for one player to keep the advantage, just for one player to stay steady, more consistent through games and games after games. Very up and down, to say the least. It's been a battle of really the receiver. Look at that return. That's the best return of the match for the Italian. The 9th winner of the match. Wow, she's definitely stepping into the return much more here in the second serve, especially. Talk about a ninth winner of the match. It was also a total of 9 breaks combined. 5 for Sasnovich and 4 for Trevisan throughout the match. Look at this. Might be on the 10th break of serve. With this opportunity once again for the Italian. Oh, that's a phenomenal backhand swing volley cross court. Great adjustment steps to get to that ball. Look at how she runs to it, gets close to it, racket below the ball, and it creates a ton of topspin here. Make sure that stays in the court. One break point saved. It's really been throughout the match. What player is going to be more aggressive than the other and take the advantage sooner? Obviously, on the return of serve, it's an easier task, especially if there are some second serves to be hit. We've seen that many times from both players. Well, yet another break of serve here. And it is Trevisan once again in the lead here, 2-1. Well, looking at this winner again from the racket of Sasnovich, it doesn't look very promising. Once again, just the return serve is much more valuable in this match than the serves. 139 kilometers per hour on first serve for Trevisan. She's getting frustrated now. This last unforced error. But at least what's good is the depth. No, that looks good, actually. That really looked inside. More depth from the racket of Trevisan. But in any case, Trevisan takes this point 30-15 here. Well, we are on the verge of first player in this third set to hold after 3 breaks of serves. And it is a hold for Martina Trevisan. Well done to be the first one. Now consolidating the break and up 3-1 in this final set. And she's now double digits on the winners, 10 total for 20 and 4 for Trevisan. Very aggressive, the Italian, taking the opportunity here to come forward on the return of serve, and that paid off then with that swing volley. But Sasnov, and it is 4-1 for the Italian in his final set. Done. Taking this 5th game at love, and it is 4-1 for the Italian in his final set. It almost looked like she's changed her mind. She's going to go into cross court. Great retrieval skills once again from the Italian. Again, an aggressive play from Sasnovich, especially on the return. Ah. Just trying to be more aggressive. There's no doubt, Šašović. It's you can see the difference. Oh, she almost made that. That was one breakback point. Unfortunately missed. Šašović, a winner here in 2019. It was also Svitolina in 2018 and 2017. Before, or I should say after Šašović in 2021 was Alize Cornu. And it seems to me that Šašović is trying very hard to try to repeat here. Another chance for one break back. Still has a lot of work ahead of her, but back to the wall here, nothing to lose. Yep, I can feel it, her back being against the wall. She's definitely putting a lot of pressure and a lot more pressure on the Trevisan, being more aggressive all of a sudden. And that's what she did in the first set, which earned her a 6-3 in that opening set. And why not trying to do that again here? Now serving down 2-4. And it will be the new balls. It's surprising to me that she's so far away to return that serve. Looking at her box, this is a second serve, and look how late she's taking that ball. Should be way inside the court, more, at least closer to the baseline. Not sure what she's saying to her box, but didn't seem very happy. Definitely being congratulated. And she's saying to the players, and especially the winner, congratulations. And here she is thanking all the volunteers. A lot lot of events throughout the tournament. A lot of young players will come on Wednesday to meet the players that are playing men's player in this event as well. By the way, following this match, we will have one more match, and that will be a very weighty match between Manarino and David Goffin. But very excited here for sure in this tournament to have this this tournament, this event taking place in really a beautiful area of France, Normandy and Caen. And it has been a really, really progression in this event. The president of the League of Normandy here, Olivier Albou, talking. He's very excited about having this tournament here. He's been very involved in the French Federation. And he wants to congratulate everybody here and thanking everybody for what they give to the tennis. Tournament director here speaking and thanking again all the volunteers who's been helping. And again, there's nothing out there in sports without volunteers, so important. It's a big organization. It's been a tournament that's been growing, and the event has been growing and growing every year. Definitely a very, very proud of what they've done here in the Open de Caen. So it was 2019, I'm sorry, when Šašlović won here against Garcia in the final, but he's this year finalist of this tournament. It was a difficult battle today for sure between the two players, and didn't get a revenge against Trevisan yet, but we'll hear a little bit of comments from Šašlović. Hopefully we'll hear a few words.
Against Martina, I think it was not the first time. So, what is your feeling today?
Bonsoir à tous.
Bravo. Bravo.
Trying.
Congratulations.
Je suis très contente parce que je suis ici.
Very happy to
jouer tennis.
To be here.
Merci beaucoup pour votre invitation.
Thank you so much for your invitation.
J'aime beaucoup.
I love
jouer ici.
I love to play here.
Excusez-moi pour mon français.
I try. My French. I tried.
Merci beaucoup, public. C'est très excellente atmosphère.
There's a great atmosphere here.
C'est bien, Alexia. Bravo.
Yeah, I would like to congrats Martina. It was a really great match today. You won against me again. I'm not happy about that. I'm joking. I'm happy for you, girl. Yeah, you had a really great season, and I wish you all the best for the next season. Yeah.
Elle aurait félicité Martina et lui souhaite le meilleur pour la saison à venir.
Thank you everyone. Thanks for organization of this tournament. Thanks to ball kids, ball girls, to everyone to make this tournament happen. Thanks to Fred for your invitation. Yeah, I'm really appreciate it. And à l'année prochaine. Yeah.
See you next
Je crois
year.
Que tout le monde aura compris que Sacha Okay. À remercier les bénévoles, les organisateurs, le public,
nice.
La presse, et je crois avoir compris en français à l'année prochaine.
Yes, à l'année
Merci
prochaine.
Beaucoup.
Thank you, Sacha. Okay.
Et maintenant, on va accueillir et récompenser la lauréate de l'Open 2022, le dernier ici au Zénith avant de traverser pour le Palais des Sports. Je vous disais tout à l'heure, elle succède à Alizé Cornet. C'est Martina Trevisan.
Martina Trevisan. It took an hour and 59 minutes for her to win this match 3-6-6-4-6-3, but she's done it. Perseverance. From Italy. We're going to see a lot of her next year for sure on the 2023 season.
Sous vos applaudissements.
A little bit of a picture here. This is a big bouquet, not easy to hold with the trophy with it.
Je crois que ce sera également en anglais.
Yes.
Yes. En même temps, elle comprend, Martina. Elle comprend le français,
here.
Mais je doute qu'elle ne se risque à prononcer quelques mots en français, quoique. Martina.
Please, Martina.
I don't speak French like Alexandra, so I think it's better if I go in English. So, first of all, thank you for the nice words that you told me. And even you lost today, you definitely killed me, like every match. And I wish you good luck for the new season to you and for your team.
Petite, c'est bon. Elle a dit voilà.
Elle a remercié et félicité Sacha pour son match de ce soir, pour tous les matchs qu'elles ont pu livrer toutes les deux. Elle lui souhaite évidemment une bonne année sportive et elle la félicite, elle et son équipe.
Then thank you for everyone who coming today to support and watch me and Alexandra. And I never been here. This is my first time, but me and my friend Bianca, we lived a very nice 3 days here in Cannes. Maybe we will come. I don't know if you want to invite me again. So thank you.
It's not so cold, you say, for difference between Italy and Normandy?
But I heard someone in Italy that right now it's 4 degrees. So we are the same right now. So I'm very happy with my win today. And thank you, everyone, the ball kids, the Chai Empire, you, and again for the warm welcome to me. Thank you.
Voilà. Merci, Martina. Elle remercie effectivement encore le public, les partenaires,
well,
l'organisation.
Well, thank you pretty much everybody et, here.
Elle espère peut-être avoir une invitation
l'année
prochaine.
She's hoping that she get an invitation. I would think that she
donc,
will get that.
Voilà. Merci encore, Martina.
To defend a title.
Elle a passé 3 journées magnifiques
and
à Caen avec son ami.
Exactement.
Voilà.
Exactly.
Say that she spent again. A great time here, the
yes.
3 days in Caen.
La photo de famille.
Yes. Wonderful. So it will be.
Et applaudissements pour les deux finalistes, Sacha et Martina.
Winner, finalist, and after this beautiful and very, very difficult final and long final, almost 2 hours.
Pendant la photo officielle, je vous précise qu'on va marquer une petite pause de quelques minutes. Je vais vous proposer un certain nombre d'animations. Je vais vous rappeler aussi que la finale, pour ceux qui ne le savent pas, de mercredi chez les hommes est avancée à 18h. Notez-le bien, 18h mercredi. Et ensuite, retransmission de la demi-finale du championnat du monde de football. On va raccompagner ces dames. Vous avez quelques minutes. Moi, je vais vous retrouver pour un lancer de balle dans quelques minutes. Un quiz tennis. S'il y a des spécialistes du tennis qui veulent jouer avec moi, on se retrouve dans 5 minutes. Et puis, un film rétro consacré à cet Open ici au Zénith depuis 2011.